five limbs of bhakti, there are actually 64 things. Out of 64 things, these five are supremely important. Holy name chanting, Srimad Bhagavatam, holy literature, Sadhu Sangha, Sri Muttaya Savara, means having deities at home and giving arati, giving, dressing deities nicely, and Madhura Vasa, going to pilgrimage, going to the holy dhams. With these five, there are 64 actually, but these five are very important to progress in bhakti quickly. Out of all, the most important thing is holy name chanting. Taking bath, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Driving, walking, nobody can stop chanting holy name. You are in the class, in the back, holy name. And you are present. Still background, holy name. But Maya is very powerful. It will make you stop. It will make you stop. And you forget completely. Oh, what I did whole day. Oh, let's start chanting. Holy name is the most easiest and most merciful. So just chant holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Nothing will stop. Nothing will, for having Bhagavatam, we have to buy books, right? For going to Madura, you have to go India, buy tickets, go to Delhi. From Delhi, you have to go to Vrindavan, Madura. Sadhu Sangha, of course, which sadhu will come out to Omaha, Nebraska? Even they come, do they stay in our house? No. Sadhu Sangha, Madhura Vasa, Sri Muttaya Savara, deities. When will even if the deities come, do we have enough time, energy, everything to serve them? First of all, deities don't come to our house, right? Even they come, that's good. If they come, that's why these five are very important. But the most easiest, most merciful is chanting holy name. We don't need anything. We need that determination to chant. This beautiful 34th verse again. Pantas dukoti satavatsara sampragamyo vayo ratapi manaso munipungavanam sapi asti yat prapidasimni avichintya tatve govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. When you take initiation, they don't sing anything except Brahma Samhita. They give Brahma Samhita and they give Diksha initiation or second initiation, Brahmana initiation or Sannyasa initiation. Brahma Samhita is so important. So important. We should learn all these verses. Pantastu. That's why I somehow, stopped Bhagavatam and just dealing again, I felt it's very important. Next, the most important book is Nectar of Instruction. Only 11 verses. As a devotee, how we should behave. So next I will go over that book. Then we'll go back to Bhagavatam. I worship Pantastu, the path, but Koti Sata, thousands of millions, Vatsara of years, Sampragamya, extending over, Vayo of wind, Atapi or Manasa of the mind, Munipungavanam of the foremost jnanis, that api, asti is, yet of whom, Prapada of the toe, Simni to the tip, Avichinchya, beyond material conception, Govindamadipurusham tamaham bhajami. Harav read 9 cantos already, Bhagavatam. Translation. But, I never read 9 cantos. I'm just going systematically. Only a third canto. So, it's all Purojanma Sukriti. Right? So, very good. That's what Srila Prabhupada want. Share this knowledge to everyone. Maybe this summer we should go door to door book distribution. I think this last summer I am new to Omaha. This summer we should do it. Door to door. It's all Prabhupada. The how we are getting access to Brahma Samhita is books. Just dropping this book, Prabhupada said, by giving this book, it's like planting this book. And someday, not even three generations down the line, if somebody opens this book, that's it. So book distribution is our family business. That's key. So I'm thinking somehow, you know, I don't know how to do it, but just go out and distribute. That's it. So this summer, we are in April. So book distribution, at least I don't know how I will do, I will pray. To please Srila Prabhupada, share this knowledge, and book distribution is the key. We should come up with creative ideas how to distribute books. So, I worship Govinda, the primeval Lord. Only the tip of the toe of whose lotus feet is approached by the yogis who aspire after the transcendental and betake themselves to pranayama by drilling the respiration, or by the jnanis who try to find out the non-different Brahman by the process of elimination of mundane extending over thousands of millions of years. I will explain it to you. So, you see, different people approach God in different ways. Now, Brahma is so smart. Each sloka, he is hitting like two chapters of Bhagavad Gita in one, three lines. Pantastu koti satavatsara sampragamyo vayo ratapi manaso munipungavanam. Vayo means people who focus on vayu, pranayama, who go to Himalayas. No God, just breathing. Yoga. Yoga poses. Vayo ratapi means meditation. Manaso munipungavana. Maybe you heard the word samadhi. People go to trance, samadhi state. And they think that's the highest, right? Vayo ratapi manaso munipungavana. Whom Brahma is referring is great sages who does these activities. Saapi yat prapadasivni avichincha tatve. People who go to yoga, who go to meditation, who go to pranayama, who go to samadhi state, who go to different routes. Demigod worship, this tantra, this mantra. With all this, where they will go? Brahma is telling, Pantastu koti, how much time they have to spend in this process is in this panta. Panta means dari, way, highway. In the highway of pranayama, in the highway of yoga, how much time they have to spend? Koti sata vatsara, koti into 100, 100 crore years in this path. And what is the destination? Pantastu koti satavatsara sampragamyo. Beautiful. Beautiful tune also. When Brahma said this, when you sing this, I am not a singer, but when you say this venum kanvanta, you have this beautiful meter to this lyric. Right? Pantastu koti satavatsara sampragamyo. People who are in this path of four things I described, it takes hundreds of crores of years, and where they go, that is very important. Sa api asti yat prapadasimni avichincha tatve means prapada means toes, foot, right? Our foot, toes. Sa that api only asti. Even though they worked so hard for hundreds and thousands and millions of years, they only go up to near to the toe, not even to the toe, they don't even touch the toe of Lord. they just go to the vicinity. Means I am here, means they stop there. If Krishna is sitting here, right? They don't go up to here after 100 crores of this thing. Brahma is telling, by the way, it's 34th verse. They stop here after thousands and thousands of years. But when you go through bhakti, the five limbs, holy name, sadhu sangha, and bhagavatam, and madhura vasa, and srimutya savara. You directly, actually Krishna will come to your house. That is the beauty. Like Prabhupada, when these Westerners used to ask, how much time for us to become Krishna consciousness? Prabhupada said, 1 second, just surrender. So yesterday, Deepti and myself were listening to this kada, where you all know Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj. He is like very early disciples and very first class. So he said, you know, he is very close to Srila Prabhupada, and one day he expressed that, Prabhupada, I want to marry. And Prabhupada arranged the marriage, and after marriage, Tamal Krishna Maharaj is very happy, right? Very happy, and Prabhupada went to London and other places, and he came back, and Prabhupada asked, how is your marriage life? And Tamal Krishna Maharaj said, my wife is really good. She chants all the time. She is first class devotee. My life is very good, spiritually also very good. And Prabhupada said, only 9 months after marriage, 9 months, right? And Prabhupada said, okay then, very good, take sannyasa. And Tamal Krishna Maharaj didn't open his mouth. He said, I'm leaving everything. So that is Guru's instruction. We never know. No questions asked. He said, I'm leaving. And then he went to Mayapur, he left Bengal, and he started preaching, and he became like BBT's main person, and Mayapur temple construction. And all those initial days, Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj is like the pillar. So why I am saying this is, imagine being born here, and even today we are talking about Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj. That is power of bhakti, where the bhakti is the direct connection, where Krishna just gives unlimited mercy. Take example of Putana, most nasty woman, right? Aho bakiyam stanakala kotam. Jingasaya apayat api asadvi. This woman came with breastful of poison to kill a baby. What is the occupation of Putana? To kill babies. That's her occupation. She goes and finds a good baby and kill that baby. Ahobakiyam stanakala kotam jingasaya apayat api asadvi lebe gatim. But when that Putana came to kill Krishna, what Krishna did? Oh, this girl came as my mother. So Krishna always look the good. Always the good. And he gave the position of Yashoda in the spiritual world. And all these munis who are meditating in Himalayas saying, oh, we don't believe in God, there is no God, there is Nirgunavatar, God doesn't have nose, everything is God, this wall is God, this watch is God. If you go in this path, you don't even go close to the God. This is not our words, right? Brahma Samhita, 34th sloka, Lord Brahma, who is the son of Krishna, is telling which direction we have to go. So, Pantastu Koti Satavatsara Sampragamyo Vayo Ratapi Manaso Munipunga Vanam సా అపి అస్తి యత్ ప్రపదసీమ్ని అవిచిత్య తత్వే గోవిందమాది పురుషం తమహం భజామి. సో what is the one word we have to take is, there are so many ways people see, like, you know, that's why if you go to so called, you know, institution, that's why in America the number one religion, do you know what is number one religion in America? Atheism. No God. Why? Because they are so bored. When I meet people, say, oh, I'm so bored of going to church, right? They don't have this rasa. Oh, I'm so bored of going to this temple. Oh, you go, he give like something and put something and you say something. It's all mechanical. We don't even know why we are going to these places. What is the science behind it? So now the fastest growing religion in America is atheism. Nobody has access, nobody has time to read the books, nobody has time to follow the instructions. So that's why when you see society, why this society is like this? Because there is no culture. When do you get culture? When you have morality. When do you have morality? When you follow the instructions of the Lord as it is, then you have the morality. So yes, that's why it's very important as a responsible person and for our progress, this is very, very important. So what is our responsibility then? Our responsibility is, we are the servants of Lord Krishna. We are only one thing, we are the servants. We are not the servants of multinational companies. We are not the servants of anything. How I can serve to the mission of the pure Vaishnavas and pure personality? What Krishna wants, what Brahma wants, and what Srila Prabhupada wants. And serving that mission is our responsibility. Getting to that Shuddha Tattva and pure devotional service, like Tamal Krishna Maharaj can say, why? I am in grihastha life. Why, Prabhupada, I have to leave family? No. If a guru says, that's it. No questions asked. It's easy to say. But if we are in Tamal Krishna Maharaj's position, we say, no, we'll think about it. Please give some time. You know, something like that. So this is all theory. Whatever we are discussing in these classes is theory. But practice is very important. Just by theory, we don't go anywhere. What is the practice? Chanting. And always thinking like, okay, 1 year back, where am I? Now, where am I? Okay, do we have Bhagavad Gita at home? Are we reading a line? Are we reading a paragraph? 1 year back, I don't have Bhagavad Gita at home. 1 year back, I am not chanting at all. Right? Now, at least I have the beads. Okay? Now, I start chanting maybe one mantra a day. Then slowly 2 mantras. Who gives certificate? In this, Krishna definitely gives certificate. Right? Pashyanti, Panti, Kalayanti. He gives certificate. There is no doubt. But the other person other than Krishna who gives certificate is me. I know what I am doing. So always, you know, once a month, just 1 minute. Where were I 1 month back, and what am I doing in my life, and how I can improve my devotional service? Initially, 23 hours, 59 minutes is for you, and 1 minute for Krishna. Slowly 2 minutes, slowly 5 minutes. If you start doing one minute, that one minute will take care of the rest. So, I mean, we all come to the Krishna consciousness like that only. So, anyways, chanting and always, at least for theory, chanting, devotee association, helping the devotees. Krishna said, who is my real devotee is the person who serves to my devotee, he is my devotee. He is not the person who directly comes to Krishna and say, Krishna, what can I do? No. People who are working and serving them, then Krishna will be more pleased. So that is practicality. And the 35th verse is, let's see. Yakaha api asau rachayatam jagananda kotim yat sekti asti jagadanda chaya yat antaha andantarasta paramanu chayantarastam govinda madhi purusham tamaham bhajami. Beautiful verse. I will read the translation. He is an undifferentiated entity, and there is no distinction between potency and possessor thereof. In his work of creation of millions of world, his potency remains inseparable. All the universes exist in him, and he is in present in all, in fullness, in every one of the atoms that are scattered throughout the universe at one and the same time. Such is the primeval Lord who I adore. So Krishna is the highest entity. So here the words, where is Earth, where is Mars, where is Sun, where is planetary systems? Everything is in Krishna. In Bhagavatam, second canto, it's beautifully described where, second canto is here. That's okay. So what it is described is the blood flowing in the Krishna is actually like the rivers. The hair Krishna has, that's okay, that's fine, that's fine. The hair Krishna has is like trees, okay? So, when, how do we remember Krishna? I will, the whole chapter describes how everything is in Krishna, right? And at the same time, andantarastha paramanu chayantarastham. Everything is in Krishna. Simultaneously, Krishna is in everything. Very interesting concept, right? Andantarastha paramanu chayantarastham. Anda means like, he. Andantarastha means samastha bhumandala, the whole planetary system. Paramanu, parama anu. Anu means atom, paramanu. Krishna is present in that smallest anu. Andantarastha paramanu chayantarastham. Govindam adipurusham tamaham bhajam. See how Brahma is systematically describing. So that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, our philosophy is achincha bhada bhada tattva. Krishna, we are simultaneously similar to Krishna, but at the same time simultaneously different from Krishna. Just like the quality is same, the quantity is different. Ocean, so big, right? Pacific Ocean. But if you see the drop of ocean, it is salty and ocean is salty. But Pacific Ocean is not equal to the salt drop. So that is the difference between Krishna and us. So anyways, I think it's, 1 hour plus. So I will pause here and next time we'll continue. It's a very in-depth purpose. So I'm just touching superficially, but please read Brahma Samhita. This is all very good for kids who can, we can teach all these beautiful slokas. Just 4 lines. And anyway, last line is easy. Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami. And the first 3 lines is the main content. So in this, everything. Brahma is like, whole Bhagavad Gita is like, whole Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita into 20 verses. Very special. Not 20, but 40. 29, we don't even read first 28, but I've gone over those first 28 verses in the last class. But main thing is from 29th. So let's see, we finished at 35. Andantrastha, Paramanu, Chayantrastham. Next class from 36.